subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
In this video, I will show you how we can check seismic drift in EDAPS 9.7.4. Let's first check variables used to determine seismic drift limit, included overstrength factor R, value of CD and total building height HN. Go to Define and click on Static Load Cases. Choose any seismic load case. Note down values of R and CD from here. Both values input here at the start of modeling. As building is dual system, shear wall plus columns, according to clause of UBC 97 1630.2.2, CD equals to 0.02. According to table 16-N of UBC 97, R equals to 6.5 for dual system, shear wall concrete with concrete IMRF or intermediate moment resisting frame. Right click on window and click on edit story data. Note down top story elevation, which is 220.25 feet. Also note down base elevation, which is minus 9.25 feet. Add both values, which is total building height, that equals to 229.5 feet. First calculate time period of building using approximate method according to UBC 97 clause 1630.2.2. T equals to CD HN to the power of 3 by 4. Input values of CD equals to 0.02 and HN equals to 229.5 feet in equation. I get T equals to 1.179 seconds. According to UBC 97 clause 1630.10.2, drift delta M shall not exceed 0.025 time story height having fundamental period of less than 0.7 seconds, or drift delta M shall not exceed 0.02 time story height having fundamental period of greater than or equal to 0.7 seconds. In this case, I am getting time period which is greater than 0.7 seconds, then we have drift delta M limit is 0.02 time story height. In elastic response displacement, delta M equals to 0.7 into R into delta S less than equals to 0.02 time story height. Rearrange this expression as 1 over 0.7 into R over 0.02 less than equals to story drift over story height. Because EDAPS 9.7.4 shows value of drift as 1 over 0.7 into R over 0.02, so we have drift limit equals to 1 over 0.7 into 6.5 divided with 0.02 equals to 1 over 227.5 or 0.00439. You can see as value of denominator increases from 227.5, resultant value decreases and building drift will be in limit. But as value of denominator decreases from 227.5, resultant value increases and building drift exceeds then the limit value. So for drift to be in limit, denominator value should be greater than 227.5 to get resultant less than limit of 0.00439. Go to File, Print Tables and click on Summary Report. Drag down pages to last where story drifts given in file. Now see all drift values are showing as 1 over 0.7 into R over 0.02. Checking drift in seismic load case of EQX, all drift values are in limit as denominator values are more than 227.5. Similarly, checking other seismic load cases of EQY, EQXPY, EQXNY, EQYPX and EQYNX and all drift is under drift limit. This is how we can check seismic drift in EDAPS 9.7.4. If you have any question, you can ask me using comment section. If you need any assistance in structural engineering or you want your structures to be designed, you can contact me through email address given. Do like, share and comment below in comment section. Also subscribe and press bell icon so that you will never miss any new video.